Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn AE tips, tricks, and shortcuts in less than 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to create a custom color picker. This is extremely useful for when you need to change colors across multiple comps or layers simultaneously. For example, backgrounds, lower third color palettes, and overall color schemes. I'm going to show you how this applies to a character that I've built from shape layers. You'll see how using a custom color picker can save a ton of time. If there's enough interest, I'd like to go over creating characters like the one you're seeing here. Okay, so this is a character that I've built, and I set the color for all the sections to red, mainly for illustration purposes, so you can see how creating a custom color picker can save a lot of time. Let's create a new comp. Control N, and we'll do 1920 by 1080, and let's call this color picker. Let's right click, create new adjustment layer. And for this adjustment layer, let's just go up to effect, expression controls, and we want to pick color control. So we need to set up a series of colors that we can then parent to our color controls in here. So first, let's just set up a new background. Since I've created the character and I've already done this a few times, I know what colors we're going to need. Let's just do some text here. We'll say skin. Let's duplicate that. Call this shirt. Duplicate that. Shirt highlight. Let's go ahead and grab all these and pull them over. We'll call this hair. Pants. Shoes. I'm just going to bring these in a little bit. Here are all of the categories that we need to create colors for. So above our skin layer, let's go to layer, new, shape layer. And we're just going to create a rectangle and add a fill. It doesn't matter what color it is. Copy the position and paste it to this. That way it's lined up to it, and we'll move it over. All of these shape layers need to have a fill applied to them. So let's go ahead and generate fill, and we'll just leave it red for right now. And we can duplicate the shape layer and then just take this Y value as we go up. So 278, 278, 438, we'll get 438. Let's go ahead and lock our effect control. So that way, if we click away, see, it stays up there. So we can always access it. We need to change the name of this color control to match all of our text over here. First one is skin, control D to duplicate, shirt, control D, shirt highlight, hair, pants, and shoes. So now that we have that, we're gonna go through each one of our squares, and we want to hit E to bring up your effects and control open the fill and alt click on our color. And we want to parent this to our shoes color right here. And we're going to do this with each one of these shape layers. So E, open up fill, and this one is for our pants. So alt click color, parent it to our pants. This one is for our hair. E, open up fill, alt click color, and just do this for every one of these shape layers here. We're going to choose our colors for each one of these categories in our color picker. And you'll see as we start to choose these, our boxes will change. So for skin, something like that. See how it's already changing. For shirt, let's go with maybe a blue. For shirt highlight, let's just pick that blue, but then kind of darken it over here. For hair, kind of brown. Pants, darker blue here. And for shoes, let's just go with a lighter color. So see, as we chose each one of these over here, they updated immediately over here. So now we need to apply this color scheme to our dude. We need to go through each one of these layers, and we need to assign one of these categories to that section. Let's just start with our head here. You can see each section here. We have hair, neck, face, beard, mouth, everything. So start with our neck. So that's going to be our skin tone. So holding down Alt, let's click on the color stopwatch, grab this, and we want to apply it to our skin color. And when you click away, you can see that our neck is already filled in here. If we just highlight this expression here, Control C, and let's just go through each section that requires skin, and we'll apply that expression to it. So hair, no, but our face does. So Alt color, Control V. Our right ear, Alt click, Control V. Left ear, Alt click, Control V. Okay, and that's going to be it for our skin tones in our head section. So the next thing is going to be hair. Alt click on the color, and we're going to pick whip this to our hair color. And again, let's highlight this expression, Control C. And now in every area that would have hair, we're going to apply that. So our beard, Alt click color, Control V. Our sideburns, Alt click, Control V. Our eyebrows, Alt click, Control V. Left eyebrow, Alt click Control V, and then our hair on top, Alt click Control V. Now we have our shoe. We're going to Alt click on our color and just drag this to our shoe. Lower leg, this is going to be our pants here. And it looks like our left shoes probably has a few different fills here. So Alt click, and I'm going to grab our shoe. Lower left leg is this part right here, and that's going to be our pants. So Control click color, parent this to our pants. Upper leg, Control click color, go for pants. Our right shoe, Alt click color, our shoe. Okay, then we have our right lower leg, Alt click color, and grab our pants. Right upper leg, Alt click, our pants. Okay, so our waist is going to need to be the same color as our pants. Our shirt, Alt click, have our shirt right there. It's like we have a few colors that are making up our shirt here. I put in a belt. You can either hide that layer, you can hang on to it. Our upper right arm, this is going to be also the color of our shirt. Actually, this is upper right arm. Collar, the shirt highlight. Okay, now we have our right hand. This is going to be our skin tone, so Alt-click color and grab skin. Lower right arm. No, actually, group one is our cuff. So let's actually make that the shirt highlight. And then we're gonna make our group two, which is our sleeve. Alt click is gonna be our shirt. Then we're gonna do the same thing for our right hand. It's gonna be our skin tone. Lower right arm, group one is our cuff, shirt highlight. And group two is going to be our sleeve. This is like where you can really see the value of this. Say we want to change our skin tone, and you saw how many layers it took to make the hands and the face and the ears and the neck. If we just change this a little bit, make it maybe darker, all of his skin tone changes immediately. So no matter what you change it to, his shirt, say you want to make his shirt green, you want to make his highlights orange, or, you know, it pops in immediately. Let's make his hair maybe black. You can change your background in your comp. It defaults to black, but you can change it to whatever color you want. So if you go to comp settings and your background color black, let's just kind of make this a pale red. You can see that better. Maybe let's make his pants, make them red. Maybe make his shoes something funky, purple. Say, for example, if your client doesn't like the color that you chose, well, if you set up this color picker in advance, you can change whatever color your client might want and get an instant result. So there we have it. And now I've added some animation to this character already, as you can see. And like I said, I would love to do some tutorials on how to build a character like this. If this is something that may be of interest, just let me know. It would require several tutorials. If you really take the time to do these characters right, you can get some really impressive results. So anyway, I hope this helped you guys out. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to comment. In the meantime, like and subscribe, and we will see you guys next time.